When you were unconscious on the beach, you kept repeating a woman's name. Anna.
I don't want to talk about that.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have pried. Where are you from, Mr. DeWitt?
New York.
What did you do there?
Business much like this. Something that really caters right in your resume.
It was a fine thing you came along when you did.
How do you think I ended up here? I gambled, and now I owe money to men you don't want to be in debt to. I come here to pay it back. Me busting you out, what do you think that was? Charity?
Who sent you?
Somebody who was willing to take my marker in exchange for you.
Turns machine and man into allies. Hold and release to create a ghostly trap.
Thank you.
So, looks like they call you the false shepherd.
And you the lamb.
Let's not call each other that.
Suits me.
How do you figure they'd know you'd be coming?
Either they've got a prophet on their side.
Har har.
Or them that hired me also wrote the signs.
Why?
Got me.
Power was time, Mr. DeWitt. Time to study things like geography.
I owed money. And there's a fellow who... He offered to wipe away my debt in exchange for you. Come on. Come on. Everything's gonna be okay. Will you just turn around and talk to me and we can...
Shepherd we've been hearing so much about. Caused a mess of trouble at the raffle.
You Fitzroy?
Nothing but.
I got no quarrel with you or your Vox Populi. This is my airship you're hanging me out of, and I got perilous need of it.
Really? Because it sure look like old Comstock's airship to
Listen, I ain't looking for a fight.
There's already a fight, DeWitt. Only question is, which side you on? Comstock is the god of the white man, the rich man, the pitiless man. But if you believe in common folk, then join the Vox. If you believe in the righteous folk, then join the Vox.
I just want my ship.
And the Vox shall give her to you. But first, you must help the Vox. Down in Finkton, there's a gunsmith who can supply weapons to our cause. Get our guns from him, and you shall have your ship back.
Find Elizabeth before she lights out of here.
The most common complaint I hear from the working man is that they are unhappy with their lot. Why don't you bet yourself?
Fire the man?
Flying squad came and took him. You ain't gonna see that. Come no more.
Hey,
wasn't born deaf.
I hear what it is people are saying. But why is it, Mr. Fink, that we have to work 16 hours a day? No, let's be clear. I would like nothing more than to shorten your work day. But the fact is, I simply can't. Why not, you ask? Well, I can sum it up for you in one word. Morality. You see, my friends, the idle hand is the tool of the devil. You take industry from a man's hand, what goes in its place? Whiskey, women, and the dice. And I, for one, will not have that in our friendly little town. No, sir, I will not.
You wanna know what we do to pretty little stowaways? Or maybe you don't.
Hey! Just stop for a minute!
Stay away!
I just want to talk to you!
I said stay away!
No! No!
Just hold up for a minute!
Stay away from me!
I'm not angry
stay
with you!
Stay away!
Hey, watch out! Move it! Move! Damn it!
I am not going with you!
Don't go in there!
I have no need of one such
Leia,
as you!
It's her.
No, no, no!
Call it
in! No! Let me go!
We got her!
There's gotta be another way.
Me.
My patience
Stop
is done run out!
Thank you.
To get our airship back.
You can get us out of here.
Yes. I just need to supply enough weapons to arm an entire uprising.
And where will we get these weapons? From one of our many friends and allies?
A gunsmith in Finkton. Should be a walk in the park. What do you say? Partners?
You're a liar, Mr. DeWitt. And a thug. But you're also my only means of reaching Paris. Comfortable with my company, Mr. DeWitt. You are a means to an end. No more.
The most common complaint I hear from the working man is that they are unhappy with their lot. Why torment yourself, I ask? The ox cannot become a lion, and why would you want to? Who wants all those responsibilities and worry? You do your job, you eat your food, you go to sleep. Simplicity is beauty.
Daisy Fitzroy.
She's either a great hero or the worst of scoundrels, depending on who's here.
She's good for an airship. I don't care if she's the Queen of Holland.
Please come again.
Can you open this, Elizabeth?
It's done. Over there, the service elevator. It should take us down to Finkton.
And get ourselves killed in the bargain.
You better stop fighting right now.
What is it? He is not a knife in the back of our prophet.
Perfect time.
Slate's locker. He must have worked here. This is my mother's diary. Why would Slate have it? My husband claims the child was created from whole cloth by divine will. I am a believer, but I am not a fool. His bastard shall not be raised under this roof. My mother. She had me locked in.
Elizabeth.
I just want to get out of this city. Please.
Greetings. My name is Jeremiah Fink, and I want to share with you my personal creed. What is the most admirable creature on God's green earth? Why, it's the bee! Have you ever seen a bee on vacation? Have you ever seen a bee take a sick day? Well, my friends, the answer is no. So I say, be the bee! Be the bee!
Hello?
Mr. DeWitt?
Yes?
Hold for Mr. Fink, please.
What's going on?
DeWitt,
think here. Listen, my boy, we've had our eye on you, and I can tell you right now that you are our top candidate. Top! Now, my associate, Mr. Flambeau, will help you with anything you need.
What the hell was that?
I have no idea.
He seems oddly pleased to make your acquaintance. Well, the man's got an ego.
Find a variety of supplies here.
Need money?
Should see you through your visit.
That'll do.
What does Mr. Fink want with us?
Excuse me, miss, but Mr. Fink's interest is strictly in the gentleman.
But why?
So sorry, young miss, but any questions regarding the gentleman's application should be taken up with Mr. Fink directly.
Does this strike you as good news? Doesn't strike me as good news. What do you think? Head to the gunsmith or scavenge supplies by that clock shop?
Nine minutes speed, now eight. Seven and a half. 6 minutes and 15 seconds.
6 minutes and 5.
5 minutes 50. I could do 5 and 50.
5 and 50.
Some folks just aren't satisfied with their place here at Fink Industries. But I tell you, there's a purpose for all living things. With a
starting bid of 20 minutes. Can I get 19?
18.
18 minutes. Without 18.
The captains of industry have been able to ride the rails, had not the Chinamen laid the track for them. So I say, chin up. History is built on the backs of men like you.
Want to hold on to this? Hooker, here.
Great.
Gunsmith.
Grab that lockpick. Mabuda.
Who?
The founder of Buddhism. Spent 49 days under a Bodhi tree until he achieved enlightenment.
Someone tells me Comstock doesn't cater to idols getting worship that ain't him.
Hello? Hello? Mr. Lin? Chen Lin? Is anybody here?
What happened here?
Someone worked this place over. Local constabulary, no doubt.
Someone downstairs.
Excuse me. Ma'am, I'm sorry to bother you. We're looking for Mr. Lin. Mr. Chen Lin.
Booker.
Mr. Lin, not here. He gone.
Gone?
They take flying squad. I pray, Gautama Buddha. Pray, give husband back. Give back to Mei-Lin.
Where did they take him?
Club. Everyone take to good time club.
Where is this club? Ma'am, please, where is this club?
Booker will find it. Just leave her be.
Why not Vox Populi help Chen Lin? Why not Daisy Fitzroy help Chen Lin?
Cops. The kind who probably got their boot on Lin's throat asking him how well he knows Daisy Fitzroy.
Isn't she the one we're working for?
As a matter of fact, it is. Let's figure out where this good time club is.
Watch out!
brains.
I don't much care for you, Mr. Dwayne. Admit you know your way around a brawl. That's all I've got. I'm sorry about what I said at the docks.
Yeah, can't see how I might have changed your sense of that.
Protected.
Job's a job. Head inside and find Mr. Lin. And just call me Booker.
Chenlin, get the hell out of here.
Now, all I ask is that you finish what you started to it. Wouldn't want to disappoint the other applicants. Our first candidate is a veteran of Peking. Now, what's that they say about old soldiers? Frankly, my money's on you. He's something of an old hand at handling explosives.
There, that one!
Only man I know who hasn't lost a limb working with them. Yet.
I'm a fireman!
Go ahead.
There you go!
That'll do.
opening acts. Your true rival is an expert with the automata. Wants to replace all our security with machines. I'll give the old boy credit, though. It would be fewer mouths to feed.
These truths to be so...
Interested in your job, Fink.
Now, I know all about your little job for Fitzroy. But do you really want to take her offer over mine? Do you know how many people would kill to be head of Fink Security? You're a tough nut to crack, Mr. DeWitt. A tough nut. But I promise you this. I will get what I want.
There's a door over here. I think that's the way down.
You're a modern woman. 1912.
It's gonna be 2012 before I'm interested in one like you.
What was that?
Fight!
Help with this.
No problem.
I used to work for folks like Fink.
Really?
And I was with the Pinkertons. They call us in when the workers got restless.
To do what?
Demonstrate the folly of men striking, throwing down tools.
You hurt people.
I'll tell you this. Sometimes there's precious need for folks like Fitzroy.
Why?
Because of folks like me.
There you go.
Idea what it deciphers?
No. Let's keep an eye out.
Tell us what you know about Fitzroy, you goddamn gook. You know you can hear us. You want to say something? Or you want us to bring in Mrs. Lynn for company? Throw a bucket of ice water on him. We've got three more to bring in tonight.
Down here.
They treat them like animals.
Someday, rain.
What's going on?
Beat him to
death! I'll crush you like a bug.
To deserve to be locked up in a place like this.
Fink don't need much of a reason.
No. No, he doesn't. You hold on to this. Okay.
Locked.
Seems easy enough. This is it, isn't it?
Yep. Number 9.
All done.
DeWitt, you're a lion. But you can't blame me for looking after my own interests, can you? Now I know Fitzroy has come calling, but I think you'll find your business with her has come to an end. Lions walk with lions, DeWitt. Not hyenas!
Now we need to find someone else to make those guns.
No.
Dead is dead, Elizabeth.
Dead is dead.
What? Where the hell did...
I see heads.
And I see tails.
It's all a matter of perspective.
Why are you following us? Who sent you? Comstock? What do you want?
What do you see here, from this angle?
Dead.
Listen.
And that angle?
Alive.
Booker. Chen Lin.
This is becoming rather awkward.
The body's gone.
It was never here.
It's another Columbia.
A different Columbia.
The same coin.
A different perspective.
Heads.
Tails.
Dead.
Alive.
We have to go through to this other Columbia, but...
It's like riding a bicycle.
One never really forgets.
One just needs the courage to climb aboard.
If we go into this tear, I don't think I'll be able to bring us back. Are you sure you're ready? I can open that tear whenever you're ready. Ready now?
no blood.
And no body.
It's another world, Booker. Another Columbia.
Something tells me one dead gunsmith ain't the only thing that's changed.
Where he was never murdered. Somewhere we'll find out why, I suppose.
I don't suspect you can change something like that and have everything else remain the same.
These men.
I killed them. They were dead.
Just not in this world. Look at their noses. They're all bleeding.
What's wrong with them?
They remember.
Remember what?
Being dead.
What is going on here, Sandmark? As my head of security, I suspect you are going to find out how
great!
He was the one who was strung up on the wall.
In the other world? This whole business makes my head hurt.
I found some money. Want it? Cash.
Great. Timing.
Where is he?
Fink isn't giving you the job. Hear anything?
Huh?
No machines. No tools.
Let's go find that gunsmith. Maybe he's upstairs now.